But how many people actually know what that means and why a leadership position in Congress is so important to Louisiana?
Tonight, Eric Paulson takes us to Washington for a day in the life of the Majority Whip, and the power Scalise has amassed in D.C. may surprise you.
Members of the House leadership come into the Capitol building through a private door after being dropped off along with their security detail. And that's where we greeted Congressman Steve Scalise to follow him through a typical day. Actually, he was at another meeting before he came to Capitol Hill, and his schedule for this day is a full one after spending a weekend at home in Metairie.
So every week that after we fly in, we have a meeting with our full Republican membership.
After exchanging a few pleasantries, he was off to a meeting with House Speaker Paul Ryan and House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy. Scalise has made remarkable progress in his recovery from a gunshot wound that nearly took his life during a Republican baseball practice last summer. After meeting with House leaders behind closed doors, he and the rest of the leadership team meet with the press, where a number of topics are touched on, including tax reform. Then we finally make it up to his office for a staff meeting.
And then this is my office. It's right over here. So this is one of the probably more historic offices. This used to be the majority leader's office. So if you could see just beautiful office space.
This office, which is decorated with a lot of Louisiana flair, is prime property in the Capitol building, with a painted ceiling and a million-dollar view over the steps of the U.S. Capitol. It's part of the trappings that come with this position and the power of Scalise's office. Actually, this room is just a small part of the office space the Majority Whip occupies. There are staff members in two halls on this floor. Scalise's total office space occupies parts of three floors in the Capitol. He has some 30 staff members here and about 10 more at his district offices back home. When Scalise is in his office, his staff, many of whom call him the boss, come in and out to take care of business before he moves on to his next meeting with Speaker Paul Ryan.
We're working on the farm bill, so we're going to talk about that. Okay. Probably talk a little bit about the rescissions package that the president sent to Congress later today. We had the OMB director, Mick Mulvaney, who drafted it, come.
To get there, the congressman takes a back spiral staircase along with his ever-present security detail. And for a man still recovering from a severe injury, he moves quite well.
The more you're walking around, it really is what strengthens the muscles again. Build back the strength just by doing.
And you're determined to get back.
I want to get back. I mean, I want to get to where I can run again. You know, and that's going to be, you know, depending on whether the nerve damage repairs itself.
Then he's off to his meeting, and this is just the beginning of his day. After his meeting with Speaker Ryan, Scalise is scheduled to address a Chamber of Commerce meeting being held by a fellow member of Congress from Texas.
See the Aggies?
Give it to him.
Yeah, go Tigers.
Scalise gets a standing ovation from the Texas crowd, which impresses Congressman Bill Flores.
How's that for a warm welcome?
Wow. So, once I talk about LSU football, it's going to change real quick.
After a fairly quick speech, he is off for a vote on the House floor with reporters camped outside House chambers. Then he was finally able to sit down with us in his meeting room off Statuary Hall, which more than a century and a half ago was the floor of the U.S. House. Before Scalise came to power, this was office space, but the new whip said, with so much history here, that had to change.
I came in and we looked around and I said, how can you have all this history and not share it with everybody else? And so we redesigned it. We moved the staff that we need to have to run the whip's office to other places throughout the office suite we have, and then we turned this into a room where we could have receptions with members. And typically every day that we come in for a new week of votes, the night that we come in, we usually have some dinner here, and you'll get over 100 members of Congress just congregating and meeting, and you know, you get to know each other better. And members didn't even know this room existed, so now everybody knows the Lincoln Room. But when I learned all the history of it and I decided to make it a room where you could literally have meetings again, I said to the architect of the Capitol, who runs the Capitol, I said, can I call it the Lincoln Room? He said, you can call it whatever you want. So I started calling it the Lincoln Room, and I tell members we're having a meeting in the Lincoln Room, come on by.
And Scalise says it's important to remember the history of this place. It's something he never takes for granted.
while you're here, you ought to also appreciate the history and the people that came before you. And to be in a room like this where you can truly feel, you know, I'm sitting where Abraham Lincoln used to sit. And you can look out that window and you can literally see down the mall and look at the Lincoln Memorial. And so we wanted to tie all that history together, and members really appreciate it.
But the most important thing for Scalise is taking care of the business of his district and the office of Majority Whip.
It's a big job. We have a lot of responsibilities. When there is a bill on the floor and we're moving our agenda, it's my job to make sure we have the votes to pass the bill. So it's a big deal. And I'll have a lot of meetings with the president or with his top staff, as well as our leadership as we're moving something, to make sure that we have the votes. And if we have issues and we need to bring a group of members over to the Oval Office to sit down with the president to work through something, I can get that meeting set up.
And for Louisiana, it's been a long time since a member of Congress held a leadership position like this.
So Hale Boggs was the last Louisiana House member to be in leadership. He was the majority whip, then the majority leader.
So how did Steve Scalise get there?
You know, I've always had a philosophy.
Are you that smart in politics?
I really think it goes back to the old adage of hard work. You know, I really do take my job seriously. I consider it an honor to represent Southeast Louisiana, but I also believe in building relationships. And, you know, I served in the Louisiana State House. I learned a lot there about, you know, the battles in politics. And clearly there's, you know, there's battles and divides politically, but there's also a real important need to build relationships with other people if you want to be effective.
Since he made news around the world after nearly dying on that baseball field, Scalise admits his profile has gotten a lot larger, and that means he's in pretty big demand. That helps him with his party and has made him a power player, not just in Louisiana, but around the country.
I'm asked to help a lot of my colleagues around the country that are in tough races, and I think it's important that we keep this majority and continue to move our agenda. And so, you know, it's great to be able to help other people and build better relationships. And it all helps to you know, kind of create a strong bond with members from all around the country, which ultimately helps me get more things done for the people that I represent.
And I know your next thing you're doing is physical therapy. You got to get going to that. You're making great progress.
I've got a, you know, kind of a never give up attitude, and persistence has gotten me where I am today.
From there, it was back out to Statuary Hall to say goodbye. But Scalise's day was hardly over. Leaving the Capitol building, he was on his way to what he describes as a grueling physical therapy session. And Scalise's long day didn't officially end till almost 10 o'clock that night with an appearance on national television.
But look, I support Chairman Nunes and what he's doing.
Tomorrow, we'll look at the more personal side of Steve Scalise and how being in a position of power in Washington has changed his life. Eric Paulson, Eyewitness News.